Hello, this video is about how to query Rightmove with LangChain using OpenAI, Python, and BeautifulSoup. You could also call it Webscraping with OpenAI. So, first thing to do, provided you've got an OpenAI API key, which you can find the instructions for elsewhere, you want to import your API key so that you can actually make requests. Then we're going to be using LangChain. So if you don't already have it installed, it's probably best to start a virtual environment and then install LangChain. Pip install LangChain. We'll be using statistics just because I want to use mean and median for the purposes of this video. Import requests, and then from bs4 import BeautifulSoup, as you can see on the screen. I'm not just going to read what it says on the screen, don't worry about that. So what we want to do is specify a model. I'm going to be specifying GPT 3.5 turbo. If you want to try 4, I understand 4 is actually quicker and better at certain things, so might be worth trying 4, or go for one that's cheaper. I know there's different prices for different models, so yeah, that's going to be ever changing, so it's no point me kind of talking about that in depth as of June 2023. What I want to do is extract some data from Rightmove using this URL. So I'm going to be looking at rightmove.co.uk property for sale. I'm just going to randomly choose 3-bedroom properties in Bath. So if I show you, what I did was just choose 3-bedroom properties in Bath with a price limit. I got 9 results. The Rightmove website will return, I think it's 24 per page. I didn't want to go beyond that because I know I'd need to get into the load more and the iterative process of going on to the next page and so on, which is beyond the scope of this video and not really relevant. So 9 properties, and then I just double check to see that the div class equals property card dash price value, and there we go, the price. So the price for the particular one that I highlighted was 299, so it must have been that one. The prices are actually hidden by the, or they're not actually text, so you will need to pay attention to what I show you next, which is, let me just go back, the tools. So with LangChain, you can use tools. Tools are a way of allowing you to go off and do other stuff which ChatGPT is not able to do. For instance, access websites. So we're going to write 2 Python functions in Python. We're going to use the at tool wrapper. You might not have seen this on every tutorial, and it's in the LangChain documentation, but not everybody's talking about it or using it, and it does save some code. So at tool, the at tool decorator, and then I'm going to get the median price, and I'm going to do another function, because the whole point of this, I wanted to show how you could use 2 tools, both custom tools which you create, and then further down I'll show you the logic to actually work with those. Headers, usual for web scraping. I'm on a Linux computer, so Ubuntu, Linux, x86, etc. You can either look that up in your browser tools, or you can Google for that, and you can just copy that in. That's just text, really. Just paste that in to some curly braces. Response equals requests.get. We're making a get request to the URL, which I just showed you. So just get all of that URL up here. It will be quite a long URL, so it will probably go off the edge of what you can see on Jupyter Notebook, if you do it at Jupyter Notebook, or whichever IDE you're using. So scrape the content. Soup equals beautiful soup. And then we're going to get response.text, and we're going to specify the HTML parser. There are other parsers available which you can experiment with. I forget the pros and cons of each one, but probably worth sticking with HTML. Props, so properties equals soup.findAll, where the div class, well, the class equals search L search result is list. So that's going to get the div that contains all of the search results. And then within those search results, we're going to find where the class equals property card price value. So on that page where you saw the 9 results, we had a card with 9 results, and then we're just going to iterate through. We're going to get the text. We're going to get the actual text from the response. We're going to replace the commas because it was kind of presented in human readable. Comma separated with the 3 zeros at the end were preceded by comma. Remove the pound sign, because what we want to do is we want to actually do some calculations with these prices. So we're going to add them all together, and then we're going to work out the median, which is here, statistics, median, all prices, and then we're going to round it to 2. Obviously, that gives us the final accurate result in pence. Mean, virtually the same. You could actually have done this as one function and just passed in the parameter whether you wanted to do mean or median, and that's how you would do it in the real world. But for the sake of this, I just wanted to keep the two functions separate just to keep it clearer to understand. Get median price URL. So passing in the URL, that's the one. And I'm just saying URL equals URL. At the end of this, I'll just quickly show you how you could port this to Streamlit or actually put a front end on it. So the two functions, they both tested, and so far we've not actually used OpenAI. This has just been two functions and request.get to Rightmove. So this is the kind of OpenAI specific bit. And you can see tools. So the tools are the things that we've written. Get median get underscore median underscore price, get underscore mean underscore price. You could also pass in some built-in ones or some that get included with LangChain. So you've got math, search. There's quite a few. I think there's about 18 or 20 or something like that. That's all in the LangChain documentation. This video is all about writing your own. So then we set up the agent. The agent is basically like if somebody you order about, you can give orders to. So you say to the agent, initialize yourself, take these tools, use this language model. The agent equals, and then you've got to kind of define what the agent does. So it's a chat agent, zero shot, and it's kind of like respond and then act, description. And it uses the description that you pass to it in the template. Create a prompt from a prompt template with one input variable. So calc type. So that's going to be a variable for the instruction that we pass in. And you can see the calc type here is in, it could be a list if you had more than, well, it is a list. So we've just got one input variable, but if you had more, then you would just put a comma and just keep growing that list. I've used that one variable in this template description twice actually. So you've been given access to search data from Rightmove. Please calculate the calc type based on the response using the calc type tool. So obviously I'm going to pass in, for instance, mean, and then it's going to say please calculate the mean based on the response using the mean tool. I probably should have concatenated that with the full name, get underscore calc type underscore price. It works anyway, so I guess if at first you don't succeed, then go back and refine your prompts. So the result is what we want, and that's what we'll be presenting to the end user, and that's what we will actually be displaying if we do a GUI with Streamlit or some such web GUI. Agent.run. So it's always agent.run because we've defined the agent up here. And then what we want to say is prompt.format prompt. So basically we're saying reorganize the prompt and transplant the word mean into wherever you see calc type. So if you're familiar with Ginger, it's kind of transplanting a variable inside of some curly braces. So what that template will ultimately say is, please calculate the mean based on the response using the mean tool. When we run it, I've run it so many times today, I'm not going to run it again, and you'll just see the same thing. I will demo it in Streamlit in a second, so yeah, don't go away. And subscribe while you're at it, because algos, and if I don't keep moaning on about it, then other people might say about it more, and then they just go really high, and you'll never see these amazing videos. So, observation, that is the mean. So based on the 9 houses that it found, it's then calculated the mean. So what we've done here is we've used LangChain to make a decision based on some information that we told it. And then it was smart enough to say, thought, we need to calculate the mean of some data from Rightmove. Action. You see, action, this is the clever bit. Action equals get mean price, which is the name of our function. If we hadn't passed that in, it may have tried to, I don't know, it might have tried to do that just using its model, which it was built with in up to, is it September 2021? So this is partly inspired by the LangChain Pinecone videos, especially the James Briggs ones. So yeah, credit to him and some other articles that I've kind of merged together to produce this video. So this is the code. It's on GitHub. I'll put the link in the description. So what I took this and then I converted it into, okay, so you can see the files I've created, a .env file containing the API key, app.py, which is a Streamlit Python file, and requirements.txt. The requirements are in here. The code. So all of this is kind of what you saw in Jupyter Notebook. It starts to change when I import Streamlit, which starts here on line 22. So I'm just going to get rid of that. Import Streamlit as ST, Streamlit title. So model. Here we are putting in an input box to enter the link. If you don't put in the link, then it will just, I've left in URL twice there, I should take that out really, but yeah, just for the purpose of testing, I've just left that in with URL equals HTTP all that long. We've got two tools that you just saw, and just down at the end, the only real difference is I'm doing calc type, which is an input, so you can either say mean or median, and then if the get summary button's been clicked, then you get the spinning timer, and then you run the agent and then wait for the result. So I'm going to run that. That's an old API key, by the way, so don't even try and use it. Right, run the app. Okay, in actual fact, it doesn't matter what I put in for the link, but I'll just demo it anyway. So, enter. And then what do we want? Let's say the mean, because it's shorter to type. And then get summary. This could all be done without using OpenAI, but the purpose of this video is to show how you can conditionally select tools. And we've got an error. Why is that? It didn't. I know why. Right, so let's fix that. So I left in I left in mean there, so I kind of hard coded it for testing, so it should be It should be whatever the user enters, so we'll run that again. So if you were going to run this code, you would just do your own search, copy the long query, the address with the full query, mean, enter to apply, get summary. Hopefully it'll work this time, otherwise I'll look really stupid. No comments. Yeah, so this could all be done kind of without OpenAI, but this is really to demo how you can. Here we go, there's the answer. So from those 9 results, the mean is 279,995 for a 3-bedroom property in that area. So you've got some apartments, some small flats. Does sound quite cheap, doesn't it? But I guess 290,000 for an apartment is not very 280,000 for an apartment is not really that cheap, is it? So that is how to convert the code to Streamlit, which there's other videos out there better than what this is. So yeah, check those out if you're interested in Streamlit. The purpose of this video is and was to show you how you can use your own tools, which you write yourself, to access the internet, because obviously at the moment ChatGPT still can't as of June 2023, and how to web scrape with OpenAI. That's not really the purpose. The purpose is actually just kind of using the agent and making decisions, watching the OpenAI make decisions, action, get mean price. So it's making a decision based upon what you told it, which is quite powerful. So what we've used here is agents, a prompt template. We've used BeautifulSoup. We've used Python, obviously. We've used LangChain. We've used statistics, and we've used the chat OpenAI. There's a deprecated version which used to be, was it OpenAI chat or something? But yeah, just make sure you get it, the new version, which is chat OpenAI. And then used to be, you might see some examples where they say model equals, it's actually model underscore name now as well. So yeah, things are changing gradually or quickly even. So thanks for watching. If you want the code, I'll put a link to GitHub, and you can copy the Streamlit or the Jupyter Notebook. You will need your own API key. I think it cost me 2 cents to do all of this with many, many tests, because we're not really tokenizing anything. All we're really doing is we're getting a small amount of text from a very small amount of text, and then we're running our own function on it. So yeah. Observation, thought, final answer. So there's a lot less going on and a lot less calls or a lot less tokens being used than if you're analyzing a large block of text, really. All we are doing is passing, actually we're passing in 9 values as a list into our function. So yeah, quite nice for testing and developing your LangChain skills. So on that note, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the future.